Welcome back everyone to another ulearn tutorial. In today's video, we'll be revisiting InDesign and want to cover pull quotes. What are pull quotes? They are these short eye-catching quotes taken from the main body of copy and displayed prominent within the layout. They can be used to break up large blocks of text, draw the reader's attention to key points, and even add visual interest to the page. Think of them as little teasers or highlights from the article. Okay, so we're ready to create our first pull quote. First, we'll grab a snippet of text from the main article, something that grabs the reader's attention. I'm going to copy it and then create a new text frame where I'll paste it in. There are a few ways to handle this, but I prefer using text wraps rather than separate text frames and threading. It just keeps things cleaner and makes it so much easier to reposition the pull quote later if needed. Let's get this pull quote looking great. First thing first, I'm making sure I have enough space within text frame to work comfortably. I start by adding the opening and closing quotation marks. Those always add a nice touch. My text is already left aligned, as this usually gives us much better character spacing, making the quote easier to read. Now, for the size. I'm going to bump it up to double the size of our border cup, give or take, so it stands out. Finally, the leading. I increased that a bit too, just enough to give it some breathing room, but I'm not going to lock it to the baseline grid just yet. I want a little bit more flexibility here. Right now, this text is snapped to the baseline grid, which is making the space a bit too long or maybe in your case, wide. If we turn off the snap, we'll have a much finer control over the line spacing and get a more polished look. Let's position the pull quote to our layout. Right now, the text is overlapping the main body text, which isn't what we're aiming for. To fix this, we'll apply a text wrap to the pull quote's text frame. We can use the text wrap panel for this. It's a really handy tool. We have a few options. Wrap around bounding box, wrap around object shape, jump object, and jump to next column. Let's explore these and see which one gives us the best result. Just below the wrap options, you will see offset. This is a handy setting that lets us create some breathing room around the pull quote. It pushes the surrounding text away from the pull quote's frame, so everything doesn't feel cramped. It's a great way to give the pull quote some visual space and make it stand out more. You can see how using our text wrap gives us so much more flexibility with the position of the quote compared to working with separate text frames and threading. Work smarter, not harder. Now here's a neat trick. I'm going to enable optical margin alignment from the story panel. This is the key reason why we put this text in its own separate text frame. Optical margin alignment affects everything within a text frame, and we don't want it messing with our main body copy. By keeping this text separate, we can apply the optical margin alignment without affecting the rest of the document. It's a ledger extra step, but it makes a big difference in the overall visual balance. Okay, let's fine-tune this pull quote. You can start it at the same size as your body copy if you like, but I think a little increase might help it stand out. I'm going to bump it just a tad, which should pull the first word back over to the left and create a nice clean flush with the edge. Now that it's formatted, I shorten the text frame a bit and then carefully position it so it's equal sides on all sides. And there we have it. Our pull quote is seamlessly integrated into the text. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on our next tip and trick. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.